I hope you're doing great. Today we're gonna do read aloud. Remember the bears and the bears and the golden rule? And let's find out what Susie is holding in her hand. Let's find out today. Okay. Here, she said, "Silly, you dropped this. It was sister's new locket." "Yay," said sister, "thanks." It was all she could think of to say. Sister climbed off the bus and watched as it pulled away. She could see Susie looking back at her from the window. Sister hung her locket back around her neck. What if Susie hadn't noticed her drop? It might have been gone for good. Mama was waiting for sister as she climbed the front steps. "How was school today, dear?" asked Mama. "Oh, okay, I guess," sighed sister, dumping her school bag on the armchair. That's an armchair. In the living room, she glanced up at the framed sampler of the golden rule over the mantel. Somehow, the golden locket hanging around her neck felt heavier than before. Ooh. That evening at dinner, sister was unsure, thoughtful. She picked at her lima beans and started off into space. "A penny for you, dots," said Papa, as he fed Honey Bear. "Huh?" said sister, looking up. "Oh, I was just thinking about that golden rule inside my locket," she explained. "I don't really get it. What's it supposed to mean?" "Well," began Mama, "let me give you an example. Do you remember that trouble you had when Queenie first moved to town?" Sister Ed parked up the pail at attention. She remembered it all too well. "Do you remember how Queenie started an in-crowd but kept you out and made fun of your clothes and hair, bow?" Mama asked. "Do you remember how badly you felt?" "Boy, did she ever," sister started to feel hurt. "Just thinking about it, her lower lip began to quiver, and a tear came to her eye. "All the golden rule is saying," Papa continued, "it is that you shouldn't turn around and do that same sort of thing to someone else." He paused to scrap some mashed potatoes of Honey's chin. "You should always treat other people the way you would like to be treated yourself." "But I would never do anything like that," said sister. "Besides, I don't have an in crowd." "Oh, no," said brother, who had been talking all this. "What about Lizzie and Anna and Millie and Linda? You play with them all the time," But I never see you ask anyone else to join in. That's different, protested sister angrily. I am just playing with my friends. We are not trying to keep anybody out.
And let's see tomorrow what's gonna happen. And I hope you enjoyed the reading we read today. And I hope you enjoyed the Berenstain Bears and the Golden Rule.